Hello everybody, welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video. Today we got the W990 out. We got the Petcar MX13, 510 horsepower with a Eaton variable 15 speed. And we got the 53 foot utility 6000R on trailer. We're gonna go pick up a load of pallets. We got graphics mod by Project NG running.
Go straight on.
With a photorealistic reshade. Version 1.40 of the game.
Keep left and then turn left.
Keep left and turn left. As we get up here and back in,
turn left.
We'll get a look on the outside of the truck. Pretty nice truck. Wish I could have painted the trailer metallic paint like I did the truck, but it doesn't have that option, so we just had to go with the red, which doesn't look bad. I mean, it looks pretty close to the same. First drove this truck, I was like, man, I don't know, I just didn't like it for some reason. But now that I've drove it more and more, I'm beginning to like it more. It's a great truck. Let's see, cargo market. Here we go, Twin Falls, Idaho. 41,827 pounds of pallets. We're not gonna make that. We gotta get closer to the fence over here. There we go. All it needed was just a little bit more. Let's see, where does this thing have to go? Right down there, it looks like. Put it in neutral, put the brake on, kill the engine. Give the outside look here. This is what she looks like. Not a bad truck at all. I think the truck and the trailer looks pretty close to the same color. So yeah. Loaded up, let's hit the road. Got a little under 500 miles to do. A This video is going to be a little bit longer than the normal 20-30 minutes. Did we get fuel? A lot better of, yeah, we got fuel. Ever since I ran out that last time, I've always made sure I had fuel to start off with. And I picked a new load up to fill up. Turn right, turn right. Stay right and turn left. There goes that sign.
Get ready to turn right.
That trailer didn't have a liftable axle on it, so. And we should be in the other lane, actually.
Go straight on.
We will as soon as we get the green light. Well, they tell you should, when you pull up behind a car at a light or something like that, they tell you you should stop, see where you can see the... where the rubber meets the road on the car in front of you, so you can see the back tires. Nobody ever does, though. We'll stop something like that. I guess that's so, see if he accidentally put it in reverse or something. I have no idea why, but that's what they say.
Keep left, and then turn left.
It to be in the handbook.
Turn left.
You don't believe me? Look it up. I didn't ever always do it. Every time I did, the car from the lane tried to squeeze in front of me, thinking I'm letting them over. Kind of pointless. Thing. You're not supposed to come back over into the lane until you can see the vehicle in your rear view mirror when you're driving the car. People don't do it. They just cut right in front of you. They don't care. I do wish this thing had a little bit more powerful engine than what it got, but it's alright.
Keep right.
The still gets the job done. It just takes a long time.
Exit right. Keep right and then turn right. Turn right.
Should be getting my new steering wheel and pedals and shifter in the next couple of days. So,
go straight
looking
on.
Looking forward to that. Be nice to have a steering wheel again. Been using this controller for 4 years now. This controller, the one I had before, was an Xbox 360 controller. This Xbox One. I wore the 360 one out. Little thumbstick. Didn't have more spring to it. It would never spring back in the middle. Just kind of stayed where you left it.
Get ready to turn right.
Always go across this damn bridge every time. Never fails. Throw load suspension gauge, say, over there. 110? Yeah. So we're about 80,000 pounds. Gross. If that thing's correct. Your speed and there's cops out. We got the traffic offenses turned on. This thing, let me see the fuel mileage. Last time I checked it, it was like 2.9 miles a gallon. It's 3.1 now. Well, this trip will put me over 1,000 miles on this truck. That almost looked like a CRST truck there for a minute. So I've never been able to get no traffic mods working, like real traffic density or, you know, brutal traffic or anything like that. That has to do with the traffic on version 1.40. It just crashes the game when it loads. Don't know why, but it does. Even if I'm not using Coast to Coast or Canada Dream or Mexico or whatever, the standard map. Still crashes. One I can't figure out. I don't know how to read the crash log. It just looks like a bunch of gibberish to me.
Go straight on.
Yes, ma'am. straight on we will go. I thought I was speeding on the copter. I was like, whoa, we were only doing 55. Downshift, come on. See, this right here feels like we got a full load on the truck. Guess it's never like that because I always put the most powerful engine in the trucks. There was a car back there behind me. He went way back there, but was turned off or something. Trucks right lane. Wait station 1 mile. All trucks right lane. 65. Divided. Highway. You actually gotta call that shit out when you take your test. Wait station exit. Mile an hour. Speed limit. At least they made me call all that shit out when I did the road test. Gotta call the shit out. You gotta make sure you check your mirrors, check the gauges every so often. 80,908. That's close. Well, those clouds are getting it, aren't they? Never really noticed the clouds moving before. Low moving vehicles next 6 miles. Oh yeah, that's right. That 35 mile an hour downhill. Percent grade. The right lane must exit. I don't want to exit. rich I collect. Never had to use one of those. Hope I don't ever have to. This ain't a bad truck at all, really. Observe fire restrictions. All trucks left lane. Another pre-pass. Green light, good to go. Back over to the right lane. Hammer down. 65, 65. Exit right. Usually this exit is blocked off. We usually had an accident right here. Not this time. To National Park. Let's see how we're doing on fuel. Still good on fuel. Trailer's still back here. She ain't falling out the back. Overheating, got great oil pressure, batteries are charging, air pressure is excellent, transmission's cool. Oil temp is good. Secondary tanks are good. Okay, good air pressure. I didn't put no CB. Oh well. I'm gonna let me talk trash on there anyway. Like the Jerry Springer show, but on the radio. And with that old bridge, good old train bridge. It's like smoky over there, foggy or something. What about me? Hell, I can't even get up past 55. Had it to the floor the whole time. Brainsville. County Road. fuel. Got a drink, don't need to eat shit or piss. We're good. Keep rolling.
Go straight on.
Yes, ma'am. Take them to make Texas. I figure at least a year or two more. I probably won't see Wyoming until the end of this year, 2021. Then again, they've been working on it for a while, so might be out faster. Need to change the gearing and the differential. Instead of a 325, put in maybe a 375 or a 410. We won't have a good top speed, but we'll have the torque to get us up and down the hills and shit. Shit, we got speed picked up now. We're going downhill. Watch out. Come on, quit downshifting. Damn. That's a valley road. Some reason they're scared or something, they don't ever go over 35. Turn that damn engine brake off. I wonder if they won't have to worry about it downshifting all the damn time. I'll have the shifter, I can control it. She had like a hold gear button. Got the hint shift, but it don't do no good. It just shifts right back up. All right, 45 ain't gonna cut it, driver. The seat out of your ass. Let's go. Really? truck. Stop. Yummy. We should stop and eat. There's a bite of Yummies. Oh no, we're going off into the woods, the forest. Watch out for the bears. I'm just flying down through here, speeding at 25, I'm doing 50. Good thing there wasn't no cops around.
Go straight on.
Oh, goddamn. Gotta keep from hitting the car with the trailer and get hit in the car in the other lane. Gotta thread the needle between them. The AIs, they always hit those parked cars going around that curve.
And then continue straight on.
Then they go in like retard mode and don't know what to do next.
Go straight on.
Oh, 5:33. Says we'll be there by 9:30. They'll turn the lights on here in a minute. There we go, lights are on. You'll get to see the truck with all the lights on it too. It's pretty cool looking. Not nothing real fancy or special. I think it looks good. Watch for rock. Why the hell is the speed limit only 45 through here? Turn fan on or something. I'd open the window, but there isn't one. Speed limit, and the sun's going down. I like the way it looks with the new lighting. When the sun goes down, sunset, sunrises, cool. They don't just pop in the nighttime or daytime. Actually fades. Go swimming in the creek down there. Station 1 mile. Big ass truck driver walk out with one of those little ducky donut things, floaties, around his waist. That'd be something. Well, should weigh a little bit less, burn some more fuel off.
Recompute. Finding a new route.
80,542.
Finding a new route.
Last one was what, 800 and something. Enjoy the scenery because you gotta drive. Damn. This truck isn't a bad truck at all. I enjoy driving it. Just gotta find a good engine to gear ratio. Apparently a 325 is not correct. I'm thinking it's probably gonna be a 375 or a 410. I think I'd probably try the 410. Let's see.
Go straight on.
That it cut down on our top speed, but hell, we can't even get above 65 hardly. Have no need to do over 70. It's fast enough.
Straight on.
going straight on. We're going 50 mile an hour speed limit. It's a nice little town.
Go straight on.
I don't know what lane I need to be in. I think I'm okay in this one. Yeah, I think I'm good. It doesn't say move over or anything. What is this, 84? Yep. Interstate 84. It's gonna be southbound. Goldfinch. That's gonna be east. 84 east. That's right. Eagle Road. Just to be on the safe side. See no truck restriction signs or anything, so 65 is the speed limit. A helicopter somewhere. I heard it. Tenth gear is a high gear.
Keep left.
Yep, ninth is too high and ten's too low. Stuck in the middle. Shit, there's a Swifty. There's a Stevenson. Interstate all the way down, so it'll be pretty smooth sailing. Yeah, this thing only got the 15 speed transmission with it, so it's got a bunch of different ratios. The Eaton Bird. versatile. Trailer screwed up at nighttime. The metal parts, the polished aluminum or whatever the hell it is, glow in the dark. Twin Falls, yep, that's where we need to go. That would be our destination. We're about 30 minutes early too. Well, we still got 12 miles to go, so anything can happen. Shit, it's dark. 40 mile an hour. Twin Falls County. Welcome to Twin Falls. Is that a fucking spaceship? Oh no, that's my mirror. Like, what the hell?
Go straight on.
They got a repair shop here. We gotta get around you. Oh, you gotta be shitting me. Really? Probably should have stopped for that one, but they didn't give us a ticket, so good. That sounds like Drake's. What, a race bus? I guess we can go. We can go for turning, maybe? That confused me. Never seen anything like it. Usually there's only 4 stoplights, not 5. My 5th one's throwing me off. A big fancy building. It would be like the town hall. Got the jail over there. Nope, it says First Christian Church. Oh, good Lord. Almost there.
Keep right.
Closer and closer.
Turn right.
Underglow going. Look better if the trailer went off. Screwed up. Yeah. Low air pressure, I know. We can bag this thing in there. Shouldn't be too hard. Oh, we got a lot of room. Not too bad. Pretty damn good. Over a little bit too far, but it'll work. Miles, 12 hours, 18 minutes, 110 gallons of fuel, $24,748. Level 131. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, leave a comment down below, and we'll see you in the next video.